Everybody, I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We're Armchair Directors.
Another trailer review for you, because you love those.
Yeah, you guys seem to rack up the hits on the trailer reviews. So finally, it took forever, but we got our very first look at The Wolverine. Coming out this summer, the X-Men. It takes place after X3. So it's...
Thank God.
It's the spin-off, but we aren't back in the Origins time. We are after X3.
Yeah.
Wolverine heads over to the Orient.
Australia, doubling as the Orient.
He goes out to, I don't know, is it supposed to be Japan?
Yeah.
And the trailer that we've got seems pretty cool. It looks like this movie could be really badass. It starts with Logan, beard, long hair, kind of rocking the Jean Valjean from Les Mis look that Hugh Jackman had. He gets into a little bit of a bar kerfuffle. And somebody
I don't think Wolverine gets into kerfuffles. I think he gets into bloody, gory massacres.
But. Somebody says, hey, we've been looking for you. And they whisk him away to meet this guy who, I guess, years earlier, he saved his life. And he thinks he owes Wolverine something. And the thing that he can give him is a death by making him no longer immortal and making him just a regular man.
Now, is this something Wolverine really, really wants? I mean, just because he's got long hair and a beard, do you buy it?
Well, so what they're trying to make it seem that the death of Jean Grey has impacted him so much that now he wants to die. And we do get a shot of Famke in the trailer.
Who's looking good.
Mm-hmm.
If that is a recently... Because she's in the movie.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that's an actual old shot they used from one of the old movies or if it's a new one, but she has those, what is it, Dutch jeans?
I think so, yeah.
Or something like that. So she's, you know, she's looking good for her age.
Yeah, and I think it's kind of cool if we're going to get some flashbacks, especially because her storyline ended so terribly in X3 that it'd be nice if we can go back and sort of retcon the hell out of it to make Wolverine and Jean Grey have sort of this better end up to their relationship.
Yeah. I'm not really buying the whole, I want to die because I'm sad because Jean Grey is dead. I'd buy it if he was old as hell.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a comic called Old Man Logan where he is old.
Like right.
It's he's so old, it's the end of the world.
Yep.
That's how long he lasted. And in that case, I can buy him as like kind of that vampire or Highlander type of immortal that I just want to die. I'm so tired of this. But this doesn't look like it's that long after X3. I mean, it could be present day.
Mm-hmm.
We're not talking like 100 years after X3. So I don't know. He's done that his whole life, right? So it's just kind of par for the course for the character. I don't really understand why all of a sudden he wouldn't want to live anymore. But it is cool that it is set in a timeline after X3, because for a while it looked like it was going to be immediately after Origins.
Mm-hmm.
There was one of the little teasers they had after the trailers of Origins where he was in a bar drinking to forget in Japan.
Right.
So I just assumed, well, the next movie's in Japan. He's going, you know, they're picking up where the old one left off. They decided not to do that. I used to follow the Wolverine comics, and the character does have a lot of history with Japan. So it's not like they just pulled it out of someone's ass. And they're like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if he went to Japan? There's actually a lot of cool Wolverine storyline in Japan with a new loved one that he meets that, you know, I won't really spoil it.
Right.
Take a wild guess what happens to any girl that Wolverine fancies.
Yep.
So it's kind of cool to see now that they've kind of ruined everything else they could possibly do with the X-Men franchise. They've got new people working on the projects and going, well, here's this thing we haven't tried yet, and here's this thing. And I'm really hoping that this ties into that new X-Men Days of Future Past as well.
Mm-hmm.
It really seems like Fox is trying to set things right.
And they're trying to connect all the movies, yeah.
Undo the crap that they did with X3. And this is their chance to actually take an old story that deals with all sorts of time travel mucking.
Yep.
And tie the first class events with possibly this one with the old trilogy, because the old trilogy wasn't all bad. It had one or two really good movies, depending on what armchair director you ask.
Right.
In addition to the crap one that kind of left a bad taste in everyone's mouth.
For sure. Now, I think the idea of Logan without the ability to just heal.
Yes.
It does raise the stakes in sort of an easy way, like, hey, we need to raise the stakes. But it also makes the opportunity for, like, Wolverine to just go berserk a few times, I think, in this. Now, they've said they want him to be like those scary moments where a guy with that much power sort of loses it.
Well,
now, if he's got everything on the line in this because he would be no longer immortal, when he loses it, there's going to be more consequences than normal.
Yeah, and he's famous in the comics for what they call the berserker
rage. Yeah, going berserk, man.
Where he just slices everything in his path, and they were never really able to do that in the movies because the movies are all about, well, not all about, but a big part of it is selling toys to children. The comics were never about that.
Mm-hmm.
It is today. Yeah, they've got tons of great toys for the comics, but back in the day when this stuff was first starting out, 70s, 80s, there were no Wolverine action figures,
and right.
The character was allowed to just do what was right for the character. As far as losing his powers, it really, I can see why they would do that, because it's a new thing to do with the character, because we've seen him take such a beating and come back from it, and there's only so many times you can have him get all hurt and crack his bones back into place and his skin seals up.
Right.
So you take away his powers and that raises the stakes, and now he can actually die, but we all know he's not going to die, and I don't really know if I want to watch my previously invincible movie characters be vulnerable, because I hated Superman 2 for that reason. Well, that part of Superman 2 where he gives up his powers and then he's just a whipping boy for everyone. I don't want to see these Herculean characters just get the piss beat out of them.
Right.
So, you know, I could see why they would go that avenue to freshen it up. But same goes for Spider-Man losing his powers in Spider-Man 2. I don't want to see my heroes lose their powers. I just want to see them go against new, interesting characters that might be able to exploit their weaknesses more.
Now, this movie is being directed by James Mangold, who did 310 to Yuma, which was great. Walk the Line, which was great.
Mm-hmm.
But he also directed Identity, which was horrible. Girl Interrupted, which is and Night and Day, that was like,
I like that one.
Fun, but like nothing special.
Yeah.
And here this trailer ends with a fight on top of a train.
Sure.
How many movies have we seen fights on top of trains? They never look real. They're not really that fresh or exciting.
Well, Skyfall.
Skyfall had a bit of a moment on top of a train, that which was not bad.
That was one of the parts I saw.
Yeah, which was not bad. But, like, there's been so many other, like, fights on a train. So, like, Logan hanging off the side of a train
Okay. Doesn't
really excite me. So I'm hoping that the action is a bit less generic than this trailer makes it look.
Yeah.
And even the visual style in this trailer looks like any other action movie we've seen in the last couple of years, with a lot of blues, a lot of oranges. So I'm hoping that story-wise, this movie really overcomes sort of those generic placeholder things that the trailer is showing us. And there wasn't any moment in the trailer where I just said, damn! And like most of these big Hollywood trailers, usually there's some moment where you're just like, holy crap.
Yeah.
And this trailer doesn't give that to me. It is the first trailer, though, so there is still time to build that up. And maybe they're saving the best for the movie.
Yeah, and I don't know if that moment is even in the movie, because right from its inception, it was intended to be a small movie
without
all of those giant X-Men cameos that Origins had, like Gambit and everyone else, the Blob and all the other guys they threw in there, Deadpool.
Yeah.
So this was always supposed to be a little tiny character thing. Now, they want this thing to be dark, and I'm wondering what happened to the filmmaker who made a dark movie that was actually visually dark, who had the balls to turn the lights down and not let you see everything and make the audience go, ah, shit, I can't see anything. Well, you're not supposed to see anything. It makes you pay that much more attention to what little I'm letting you see. Alien is a perfect example of that. Aliens as well. So dark, you can barely see anything. And it has an effect on you as a viewer. This is supposed to be the dark Wolverine movie and everything is beautifully lit. I mean, even the dark shots in this are very brightly, lit. So I wanted to see a Dark Knight type of Wolverine where you just see the silhouette of the hair, which is awesome, by the way. They really got the hair true to the comics with the little cowlicks on the sides. But I really wanted to see him totally in shadow because that's the image I think of when I think of the Wolverine comics.
Mm-hmm.
Really kind of hidden in shadow, dark.
Well, we'll see.
Yeah, I guess we will. Because it is one of the movies I'm going to go see this summer.
Definitely.
Might as well.
No, sounds good.
Big fan of Wolverine. Looking forward to it. So happy they decided to give it another chance, because I thought Origins was okay for what it was, but with each subsequent viewing, it's a bigger piece of shit.
There was definitely room for improvement, and I'm just hoping they have improved.
So it's very cool, in my opinion, that they're taking another crack at it, and it's not going to follow Origins. It's this new thing, totally different thing. And I'm actually really hoping that this is that they're taking a page out of Marvel's book, Marvel Studios, And this is kind of part of phase one of leading up to Days of Future Past. So I'm just really crossing my fingers and hoping this somehow is connected, even though they're saying it's disconnected. I really want it to be connected to Days of Future Past. I guess we'll have to wait and see.
We will find out in July. And until then, thanks for watching.
And enjoy the show.
They did to me what I am can't be undone.
Don't be so sure.